Going to Dan Johnson's wedding, and he's getting married today, about another half hour. There's his card, but you can't see it there, but it says envelope. Dan and Christen's envelope. I gave him $20, so. But anyway, I'm going to take off and go. I'm going to get married at the Catholic Church in a little bit, so I'll talk to you later, and then happy congratulations to Dan and Christen on their wedding, so bye-bye.
People who, by your presence, promise to be of support to them the rest of their through lives as a married couple. They in turn offer you a gift. They've selected all the prayers, the scripture readings, and the blessings. They set before all of us their hopes and ideals as a married couple. So for them, let us pray. Father, hear our prayers for this couple who today are united in marriage before your all. Give them your blessing and strengthen their love for each other. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
But rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Please stand for the words of Jesus. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. That is why a man must leave father and mother. The two become one body. They are no longer two, therefore, but one body. So then when God is united, man must not divide. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Dan and Christen, in choosing these readings, accept before yourself high ideals. Reading from the Song of Songs talks about the virtues of a good wife. Dan, what does the chap have virtues? It's not a one-way street. Your second reading. You have set before yourself Paul's description of love. Always patient, always kind. You'll have to work at that. It doesn't come easy. But you have the gift of your love for each other, and that will help. You also have gift of God's love and presence in your marriage. And that will certainly help. In any marriage, there are three people: the groom, the bride, and God. When God grows you, he doesn't just sit back and say, flow with love. He promises to be a helper and a support for you. Your life together as a married couple. So that all those good and strong feelings that you have for each other today will last you the rest of your lives. God makes the promise to you to be present, to be a help and support. For as the gospel says, in the beginning God planned marriage as a gift for people. Plans to be a gift that they share the rest of their lives. May that happen to the two of you. May you share that love to the days of the desire. Please rise. Through your hands. wife. You promised to be true to her in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. Love her and honor her all the days of your life. Christen, if you take today, you will be your husband. You promised to be true to him in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. Love him and honor him all the days of your life. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent, fill you both with his blessings. For when God is joined, man must not divide.